Hello, this is going to be the session that we're going to be talking all about safety and tools. It is an introductory part, but it's a very, very important part. So pay attention.
It is important whenever you're working with hand tools, power tools, or even doing basic work to have some basic protection gear. Vinyl gloves that are also provided to you is number one. Always wear them. It makes your life easier, safer. And then goggles. These are some basic power tools and simple tools that you can be using when you work with wood or metal. You can have some basic saw, or you can have an electric saw, the hand power drill or the cord drill. All of them, they are doing more or less the same work, but you have to know how to use them properly.
So when you want to cut wood, there are different tools you can use, some very simple ones, like a simple saw. So you can use a clamp to hold it. Always the piece you wanna cut, it's from the outside part of your bench. You don't try to cut it here or there, you cut here. Or if you don't have a clamp, someone to hold it really well, far away from where you cut. And then you just let the tool to do its work. Slowly, slowly. And you go all the way and you cut it. Or you can use the electric saw. So the electric saw, it has here a blade that goes up and down. It has a trigger that when you press the trigger, it moves. So you have to be careful. Always you keep it from the outside or part of the bench, of the workbench you work. And here you see this metal part needs to be in parallel with the surface you wanna cut. So you have to put it all the way down, not up, not like this, not right, not left, all the way in parallel. And you start a little bit before where you want to cut. You see here where's the blade? It's a little bit more outside. So you press the trigger. You release the trigger, let it stop, and then you take it out. Always be careful whenever you use tools like that. Always the cable needs to be also on your back. So one very important tool that we like to use a lot, especially when you work with wood or with any kind of construction, is a battery-powered hand drill. So here's the battery, you can recharge, you can take it in and out. Here, there's a trigger, that this is a main control. So as you hold it, you can press a little bit the trigger, it goes slowly. You press the trigger all the way, it goes faster. So you have control out of here. Then on top of it, it has this indication. You see that this is down here. If you turn it and you press that dial, what happens is that it changes the rotation. So when it's like that, you screw. It goes clockwise. When you press it, it goes counterclockwise. Then on top, you have this typical indication to change the speed. So here, for example, it says low. This is the low speed. If you put it like that, it's a high speed, so it goes faster. Low speed, high speed, all right? And then on the front, you have a dial. Here it has an indication that it's an arrow. So for example, in this indication here, it has a drill. So that means that when you want to drill, you have it here. When you want to screw or unscrew, then you can turn it like that, and it has here different numbers. You see, it goes all the way from zero. You cannot really tell, but it is a zero. And then you can go all the way, for example, on this little guy, you can go all the way to 16. So this, from here you control how powerful will be your screwing or unscrewing. So for example, if you want to be gentle with what you screw or unscrew, you can go very low. If you want to go all the way, you go higher like this. When you want to drill, pop, you go on this indication. So, then here in front, what happens is that you have this the input where you put all the different bits, either for drilling or screwing. So what happens is that the moment you turn it like that, you see this thing opens. So by opening it, you can actually place a drill, for example, a drill bit. You place it like that, and then you start screwing, pop, and then you screw it a little bit tuck, and now this is ready to be used. Also, when we work with wood, apart from screwing or drilling or anything, many times we want to do sanding. So when we want to clear a surface or make it smooth or anything, there are two ways to do it. One way to do is to use sandpaper. So sandpapers, they also come in different variations. But the most important, and that's why also they have also different coloring or color coding, is that when you turn on the back, they have different numbers. So for example, this one, it says P40, this is P180, this is P100, this is P400. The higher the number, that means the finer it is, yeah? So if you want to go fast in a surface and clean it really well, but very fast as a first layer, you pick a small number. So this is the number 40. So you can also tell by the way you touch it. And then what you do is that you take a little piece like that, you place it, and you start sanding. Sanding, sanding, sanding. Then after that, you might go to a higher number. So for example, from 40 that we were, we go to 180, it's smoother. And then we go through the same surface, then we can do it finer and smoother. If you want to pay a lot of attention to details, you can go to a very finer. There are even higher numbers than 400, like 1,000 or 1,200 or 2,000 even. And then you can go through it slowly, slowly with patience, and you can smooth out the surface or a side corner or anything like that.
This is a basic set of tools whenever you work with electronics or electrical thingies. This is a polymeter. You use it to measure volts and connectivity and so forth, we will explain. Then you definitely need maybe a set of grimpel tools. You will see how it works. A set of pliers, a set of little screws. A lighter is always handy, you will see why in the future. And then you will need to have maybe a silicone gun in order to make easier connections. If not, you can still use silicone. And then, of course, is a soldering iron together with a solder and soldering grease, a very important tool that you're going to be working a lot with it.
So let's say that we have these cables here, and we have this cable and we want to cut it. Then we are choosing this part here. So you take the wire, you put it in between, and when you clamp it like this, it's going to cut the wire. Pop. Then if you want to strip that end, because we need to strip it, then you go here and you place the cable based on its diameter. Typically, if you don't know which is the diameter, you go halfway and then a little bit more down, and then you keep it like that, you hold it and press it, twist it a bit, and then whoop, it's stripped. So you can see here the cables are exposed. So here you cut, here you strip. And then what you're doing is that, for example, if you want in the very end of this cable, you want to put, for example, a little thing like that. What you're doing is that you twist the cable a bit, you cut it very little like that, and you take this guy, you put it inside here all the way in here. And then you take your tool, you go in the front. It has also three different indications. You can choose, if you don't know which one to use, you can use the smallest one. So typically it's the first one here. You place it like that, and you put it a lot of force all the way. When you do it like that, in the very end, tuck, tuck, this is very well connected. If you don't have such a tool, you can do similar things with even more basic tools. So for example, you can have a cutter like that, and if you want to cut the wire, you just cut it, tuck, it's cut. If you want to strip the wire, again, you don't put too much force, you press it gently like that, a little bit around, and then with some force, hop, it came out. When you want to connect two cables, there are various ways to do it. We're going to show you the proper way, however. So you would take one end of one cable. Let's say I want to connect this black cable with the red one. So what you're doing is that you have first to strip quite a lot of piece of this. So as we show you, you go like this here. You remove it. You see now here's exposed. Then you do the same thing from the other side. And you have these two pieces together, yeah? So what you do after is that you take these two parts like this, you cross them and you twist them. And you manage to twist them minimum two, maybe three times if you can, exactly like this. And when you twist them, you have this connection. This is a proper way to connect two cables. After you do that, you can either use some electric tape to wrap it around so they're not exposed, or a better way to do it is you can take a heat shrink tube, this plastic little tubes that you can get from electronic parts or anything. So what you're doing is that you say you want to cover this part here. Huh? You don't have to use all of it. So you cut a piece like that. You put it from the other side of the cable, like this. You move it in the area that you want to insulate, and then you take a lighter and gently, as you put a little bit of fire around it, it shrinks, and that's why we call it heat shrink. And by doing it like that, maybe in the very end, you press it a bit, and you have a very nice connection that works. There's another way, however, if you want to do it even more secure. So let's say I have again these two cables I want to connect. So again, you can strip them with any different ways that you want to do it. Like this, they are stripped now. So again, you make again the same twist. All right. And then you can use the soldering iron. So the soldering iron, you put it you plug it and then you wait for 10, 15 minutes max, and it becomes very, very hot. So the tip is very, very hot. You have to be careful. So what you're doing is that after the soldering iron is hot enough, then you have the solder, this part here, that we're going to be using a lot. This is going to be your connection, yeah? And you also have your grease. This grease allows the solder to go in a unified way wherever you want to put it in order to connect cables, yeah? So what you're doing is that you place the soldering iron a little bit on the grease, like this. So now this thing has on top of it some grease. And then what you're doing is that you place the soldering iron on top on where you want to do the connection, like this. You leave it for 3 seconds to become hot. So you count 1, 2, 3, and then you melt it on top of it, you remove the soldering, and you have a connection. This is a very good connection in a way. You can do it also from the other side, like this. Again, you leave it there, 1, 2, 3, and you put, it melts, it spreads, and this is well connected now. And again, if you want, you can use again a heating tube, or you can take electric tape. That is a very important tool. Always have a good electric tape. Tuck. You put it here. You insulate it. You wrap it. Wrap it all around. Don't leave any cables exposed. This is a kind of important step. And then you can do it. Tuck. And here you have a very good connection. So this is a polymeter, which means we call it polymeter because you can measure lots of different things. On this one, it has four different signs. The one is, it says V, but it has a little curve on it, the first one. That means to measure AC voltage. The second has V, but with a flat line. It means to measure DC voltage. Then there's a Greek omega, that is for to measure resistance. And then it has this, the fourth symbol, that it makes a sound when there's connection. So by turning this dial, you know, you choose a different position and you can use it to measure different things. Then there are two cables, one black, one red, that they end up in these two signs that we put them where we want to measure. So for example, if I want to measure DC voltage, let's say of one battery, so I have the battery here and I know that this is plus and this is minus, and I know there's a battery, so this is DC voltage. So I go on the second position of the dial, here it says zero, and then I take my two cables like that and I place them in the two points that I want to measure. So for example, in this battery, I put one on one side, one on the other, and I read 1.77. So I know that this battery has 1.77 volts in it. If now I want to measure, for example, if there's any connectivity between two points, let's say I have, again, the battery. I put it here in the very end. When there is connection between two points, you're going to hear a sound. So if you have made some connection and you want to test it, you want to try it, let's say we made this cable, we connected one end to another, and we want to make sure that this connection is proper. So what are we doing is that we go on this fourth place, we put one end here and one end in the very end, and if we hear a sound like this, that means that there is connection. If for any reason you don't hear that sound, that means that there is no connection between this cable.